Hello, everybody. How lovely to have you back for a brand new week on House of Games. No ordinary week, though. It is a Champions Week. We have four players on who have won before, but only one of them is going to win this trophy. And yes, you are quite right. It is almost gold in certain lights. Who's going to win it? It'll be one of these four former champions. Alex Brooker. Izzy Suttie. Kiell Smith-Bynoe. And Kaye Adams. Hello, everybody. Hi. Champions all. None of you has the personality type of a braggart champion. You wear it quite lightly. Alex, how are you feeling about being on a Champions Week?
Yeah, good. I was surprised when I won the two shows before. So
you were surprised. mate, I've worked with you before. I lost a lot of money that week. Izzy, how are you feeling? Do you fancy a slightly golden trophy?
I do. The silver one that I've got at home, I discovered a spider had woven a nest inside it.
Whoa.
It must have thought all its Christmases had come at once.
Are you letting the spider live there?
I'll move the spider into the gold one when.
Oh, my God. That spider's going to be... Whoa. All eight legs. Check me out. Kyle.
Hello.
Hello. It's a slightly golden trophy, but...
Yeah, it would go more with my decor than the silver one does.
OK, that's good. That's why you're back, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's the only reason.
Because you think it's slightly clashing with your sofa.
Yeah.
But we have real golden prizes. And when I say real, I mean they're gold-coloured prizes. Anyone who wins today can win one of these. We have got... Look at those! We've got a golden water bottle. We have got a golden tape measure. A golden baseball cap, we've got a golden toolbox, and a golden cafetiere. Blimey, I bet you're glad you came. Which of those do you fancy?
I think the water bottle. I'm actually sick of tape measures. They're everywhere.
Ugh, please, so many. Like, did I miss a meeting about tape measures one day?
I can't believe how many tape measures I've got in my house. Yeah, I'm after the water bottle, actually.
Water bottle. Yeah. Kay, lovely to have you back.
Thank
another
you.
Champion. What would you go for, Kay, if you would
have Well, obviously the hat.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, that hat is just calling my name, don't you think?
There are certain people who can carry it off, Kay, and you are one of the few. Alex, what would you go for?
I think probably the water bottle.
Yeah.
I like the water, but a bit class about
useful,
it.
Right?
Yeah.
Izzy, what would you go for?
I think the cafetiere.
The cafetiere. Yeah. I think that'd be nice, wouldn't it? shall we get on and play a Champions Week of House of Games?
Mm.
Every time I press this buzzer, a new round comes up. We never know what it's going to be. Our first round today is... Rhyme time. It often is on a Monday. Rhyme time, our first round. Fingers on buzzers, please. Two questions. The answers rhyme with each other. Here we go. Here's your first one. 1978 film musical starring Olivia Newton-John and John Travolta. And novel by Leo Tolstoy featuring the character Natasha Rostova. Yes, Kyle.
Grease, War and Peace.
Grease, War and Peace. It is Grease, War and Peace. Very well done. Next two. 2001 heist film starring Julia Roberts, George Clooney and Brad Pitt. And English County that contains the city of Exeter and Dartmoor National Park. Yes, that is Alex.
Ocean's 11, Devon.
Ocean's 11, Devon. Point to Alex. Ocean's 11, Devon. Next two. Who is this? And pasta in the form of long, narrow ribbons with a name meaning little tongues. That is Kay.
Claire Sweeney Linguini.
Claire Sweeney Linguini. It is. That's a branding opportunity for Claire Sweeney, isn't it? Claire Sweeney Linguini. next two. Heavy circular object thrown as a sport at the Olympics. And what is this? Yes, Kay.
Discus hibiscus.
Oh, discus hibiscus. Lovely work. It is discus and hibiscus. Next two. Who is this? And what is the title of this song? Yes, Alex.
Judy Love, Take Me to the Clouds Above.
Judy Love, Take Me to the Clouds Above. Well played, it is. Nicely done. by LMC. Final question in this round. Who is this? And drug used to treat angina and reduce high blood pressure. Kaye.
Jarvis Cocker beta blocker.
Oh, it's a Jarvis Cocker and beta blocker. It is Kaye. Very nicely played. That's the end of our first round on this special Champions Week of House of Games. We'll take a look at our first leaderboard of the week. Is he keeping a powder dry for now? Kiell, you have one. Alex, two. Kaye Adams, 3 points. Early
I
leader.
I think this too nerve-wracking.
Well, it's, it seems to be working.
I need some beta blockers.
Or Jarvis Cocker, one or the other. Should we play a pairs game? Our first pairs game this week is going to be... Distinctly average. Izzy, you get to choose your partner. That's okay. Good news, isn't it? Who would you like to play with?
Alex.
Playing with Alex. Alex and Izzy are a team. Kiell and Kaye are a team. If you'll take your tablets out, please, everybody. I'll ask you a question. Write me down a number as your answer, and I'll take the average of each pair as their answer. OK?
Okay.
Here's your first question. According to the RNLI, how many lifeboat stations are there in the UK and Ireland? Everyone is in. Alex, what are you thinking on this one?
So I've gone for 200. I don't know, because it's UK and Ireland.
Yeah.
I can imagine that there's quite... Yeah, I don't know if I've gone too low there.
Yeah, because but they're not everywhere, are they?
Yeah,
but,
that's
but,
what I mean,
But
yeah.
quite often you go to a seaside town and they'll have a lifeboat station.
Yeah. So maybe
200 doesn't sound a crazy starting bid, I would say. Is he going up or down from that?
I've gone up from that, so I'm 326.
326, but not crazily different.
I guess you can never have too many lifeboat stations.
You can never have too many lifeboat stations. So your average? 263. How does that look to you, Kiell?
I'm sort of similar in
300,
area.
Says Kiell. We're all thinking along roughly the same lines here. Kaye, are we all thinking along roughly the same lines?
I think I'm lost at sea on okay. this one. I thought the answer is either going to be surprisingly many or surprisingly few.
Yes. So the averages are going to be fairly close. Your average, Kiell and Kaye, is 171.
Sorry,
so
Kiell.
171, 263. Right. Those are, yeah, I wouldn't care to call it. No. What do we reckon at home? What have you got written down on this one? Shall we find out how many lifeboat stations are there and who scored the first point of the round? 238. Oh. Very, very well played. Well done. If you said well that done. At home as well, 238 lifeboat stations. Next question. At the end of his match at the Australian Open on the 17th of January 2023, US tennis player John Isner had served how many aces during his career? That's, of course, in professional ATP Tour matches. OK, everybody is in. Izzy, any thoughts on this?
OK, I love tennis.
Yes.
I think it's either going to be very high... I mean, it'd be fantastic if it was zero. I don't think it is. And this might be a bit high, but I know he's a very good player, so I'm going to say 681.
681, says Izzy. Alex, what are you saying?
I think I might have gone a bit too low. I've gone with 300.
300. Your average is 490 and a half. Kiell, what are you thinking?
I've gone 700.
700, says Kiell.
Yeah.
Gone a little bit bigger, okay.
You're going to think I'm crazy here. I've gone 5,000.
5,000, says
Kiell. Isner was known for his serve. He had a long career. And I may be doing a bit of an RNLI again, but I'm...
I don't think you're crazy at all. I mean, he's the biggest server in the game. He must have more aces than anybody, I think. So your average, Kiell and Kaye, is 2,850. We have about 500. We've got about 3,000. What do you think at home on this one? Did you take a guess, an educated guess? Let's find out how many aces did he serve in his career. 14,000. 14,039.
Wow.
In 784 games. Very well played. A point there to Kiell and Kaye. Nicely done. Final question in this round. According to the National Peanut Board, according to our friends at the National Peanut Board, how many peanuts are required to make a 12-ounce jar of peanut butter? See, we ask the questions on this show.
I assume that's an average jar.
Yeah, that's just like your regular one you buy from the supermarket.
OK.
Everyone is in. Kyle, what is your answer?
36. And a little drawing of what I think a peanut looks like.
Oh, that's nice. Kaye, what have you gone with?
Well, I've gone bigger. Have you ever, like, when the kids were young, you took them to these shops where that you could actually make the peanut butter that would come in and it would go down? And I
no
kind
way.
Of feel there was more than that. I don't know, Kaye, you might be right, but I've gone for 330.
313, says Kaye. So your average is 174.5 peanuts. Alex, what are you saying?
I've gone for 150.
150 peanuts?
150, yeah, I think it's like a decent amount. Bit of butter in there. Yeah. That's how you tend to make it.
I think so. I tell you what, bit of peanut, bit of butter, bosh. I can't believe they haven't commissioned a cooking show from me. Stick it in a jar. Bit of bread in
Whiz
the old...
it around. There
bit
you
of bread
go.
In the old toaster. Bob's your uncle. Izzy, have you gone up or down from that?
I'm worried I've gone a bit low, actually. I've gone with 88.
88.
My logic is they often add other stuff.
Yes.
So it's not just peanuts.
It ain't just peanuts.
Bit of butter.
Yeah, bit of butter, for bit example.
That's the logo.
So your average is 119. We've got 174, 119. How many peanuts are there in a jar? Who scored the last point of the round? 540. Kaye and Kaye get another one. Ooh, that's a lot of peanuts in a jar.
They're making it at Kaye's shop.
Little room for butter. Tap this away, please, everybody. That's the end of that round. Everybody off the mark now. The leaderboard looks like this. Izzy, you have got one. Alex and Kaye, 3 points each. Kaye Adams is our leader still with 5 points. Scary place to be, Kaye.
Very.
Three rounds to go. Three rounds to go. Our next round is... win when they're singing. Now, if you put your fingers on buzzers, please, I'll play you the beginning of a famous song, the introduction to a famous song. We will then fade out the music. You have to keep playing along with it in your head, and when you think the first word is sung in that song, press your buzzer, and whoever is closest to when the first word is sung will win a point. Okay. You know how to play this at home, I think. Shall we do it? Stopwatches out and start them now. Focus, Izzy. Still going? Whoa.
She knows her music.
That, I tell you what, Izzy, if you've won this point, that's impressive stuff. The three of you went very, very quickly. Izzy held off. How long did you go, or have you got on your stopwatch? Let's take a look at your timings. The song was Know Me, Knowing You by ABBA. Kael went first. Kaye and Alex immediately panicked, because they saw Kael press his buzzer.
100%, that's exactly... I have no idea what that song was.
I don't know.
Knowing me, knowing you. No. Oh, but he said, oh, yeah, come on. Kay's gone, she's leading. Izzy held off to 20 seconds. What do you think at home on this one? Did you recognise the song? Let's take a listen, shall we? See who scored the first point of the round. Alex Brooker. I mean, I'm not going to say you just stole a point, but you absolutely did. Shall we do another one? Everybody at home, start your stopwatches now. I'm still going. OK, I'm in. Are you in at home? Is that Female of the Species by Space? Let's take a look at our timings here. We're going to be close to each other. Kaye went first, then Izzy, then Kael, then Alex, all within a second of each other. Shall we have a little listen? See who scored the point. Oh, 2-2. Alex, you've done another one. Wow, well done.
I should have held my nerve.
Yeah, you should have done.
Because it did go round twice.
Well played, Alex. Nicely done. Let's do one final one, shall we? Fingers on buzzers, everyone. And at home, please start your stopwatch now.
No. Oh, no.
Wow, they've gone in early. I'll give you a few extra seconds at home if you want them. Let's take a look at your timings. It was This Old Heart of Mine by the Isley Brothers. And look at that, all within about 8/10 of a second. Izzy went first, Alex was last. What if you did mean to go later?
It's a lot later.
Well, that's great. Well, you're going to win the point then. Are you going to nick another one?
No, that one, yeah. But I deserve this one more than the previous.
OK, that's right. I gotcha. Let's take a look, shall we? Let's have a listen and see who scored the last point of the round. Oh, I just want to listen to that whole song now, don't you? 13.8 seconds. Well done if you got that at home. And Alex, you got yourself another point. I'm not entirely sure. I would like to go back through the records and see if anyone has ever scored 3 points with the distance you were from all three of them. I would love to see what the statistical standard deviation is on your point scoring there.
Yeah.
But listen, you can only play the game in front of you, can't you?
Yeah.
It's all you can do. Great round for Alex. Let's take a look at what it's done to the leaderboards. Everyone else has stayed the same. Izzy still with one, Kiell still with three, Kaye still with five, but we have a new leader, Alex Brooker, with six. How about that? It's a good time to have a good round. We have two rounds to go on Monday's House of Games Champions Week. Who is going to be our first champion of champions? Our fourth round is... Where is Kazakhstan? If you could take your tablets out, please, everybody. We know how this works. I'm going to show you a map. Today's map is this. The United States of America. And I'd like you to find a series of things, please. Could you find the capital of the only state that has a name beginning with the letter D, please? What state is that, I wonder? What do you think at home? Do you know the answer? And then do you know where that is? More to the point. Have a little point to the screen, if you wish. Everyone is in. Alex, do you know the answer?
Is it Delaware?
But then where is Delaware?
Well, I've put it... I kind of thought it was, like, mid-where. That's where I put it. I thought it was around that area.
Yeah, why not? I mean, listen, it's a state, right?
Yeah.
Could be Delaware. Izzy, what are you saying?
Well, I thought it was Denver.
Oh, OK.
But I also didn't know where that was.
Gotcha.
So I've gone for somewhere, but I thought it was sort of westish, so I've gone for kind of west.
You are actually surprisingly near Denver there, which is in Colorado, Denver. Kyle, what are you thinking?
I had no idea.
Great. And so your tactic is somewhere in the middle? That's the usual tactic.
No, not in the middle, actually. I thought I'll go right a bit.
Okay. Kay, what are you saying?
Well, I got Delaware as well, but really didn't know where it was. I know it's not West Coast. I was pretty sure it wasn't East Coast. So middle-ish. I think Alex is probably right by going a bit further that way. I'm next to Izzy, I think.
Let's see where you are. OK, so we're in Colorado, we're in Iowa, we're in Utah, and we're in Kentucky. So no-one is in Delaware, but somebody has got to be nearest to Delaware. And, big news, we're going to find out where Delaware is. let's find out where is Delaware, who is closest and who scored a point.
Ooh.
What? Wow. That's new information. Kyle, you're closest.
Well done.
That can't be right. No way. That's blown my mind. No way is Delaware over there. Did you know that? Is this new? Did everybody know this?
Yeah.
Should we do another one? The next thing I would like you to find is this. The golf course where the Masters is held annually. Where is the Masters held? Do you know this one? Golf fans will know this one. But then where is that? is the question. Everyone is in. What do you think at home on this one? Do you know the answer? Then do you know where that is? Izzy, do you know the answer?
No, I don't know anything about golf, so I've just may as well have closed my eyes and locked in.
Lovely. Let's see where you are. South Dakota is where you are. Perfectly nice place for a golf course. They love golf courses there. Kiell, do you know this one?
I thought it wouldn't be too cold and it wouldn't be too hot, so I went...
Gotcha.
We'll call you Goldilocks.
No one is playing golf in the heat or the cold.
So I've gone somewhere else.
OK, let's see where Kiell is. Sort of Nevada, Utah-ish, which, again, there'll be golf courses there.
Nevada's pretty hot, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty hot, yeah. Yeah, I would say so. Too hot for golf. Kay, what are you saying?
I'm thinking it's Augusta.
Uh-huh.
I have it in my head that it is certainly not Florida, but in that bit above somewhere. Okay. I don't know why.
Kind of north of Georgia you are there. And, Alex, what are you thinking?
Well, and I've got it wrong now, because it is in Georgia, isn't it, Augusta?
Maybe.
So, and I thought it was that bit nearer, near around Florida. So I kind of, I've gone slightly to the left of where Kay is.
Okay. Which is Arkansas.
Ah.
So if Alex is right and it is in Georgia, it's good news for Kay. It is Augusta National. But where is Augusta National? Alex is right, it's in Georgia. It's very close to where Kay is. Nicely done. Ooh. Points to Kay, Augusta National in Georgia. Final question in this round. The capital of the state that is the main setting of Family Guy. Where is that, please? Where is Family Guy set? That's a kind of geolocation lock to... What do we reckon on this one? Any Family Guy fans out there? Where would you point on this map? Everyone is in. Kyle, do you know the answer here?
I know there's Quahog.
Yes.
I didn't know that was a real place.
It is not. Quahog is a fictional town.
I didn't know that. So I'm guessing... I think I started thinking about the accent. So yes. I was guessing it was sort of New York, New Jersey.
OK, yeah.
So this is where I think New Jersey is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, got a New Jersey borders there for sure. Absolutely. Kay, any thoughts here?
I've never seen Family Guy.
It's very funny.
Which is a confession in itself, I think. So I really haven't a Scooby. I've gone Midwest because that tends to be where a lot of humour is in the States, but I honestly haven't a clue.
See where Kay is? Yeah, kind of Idaho. Alex, what are you thinking here?
Well, I started thinking about the accent as well, and I think it's kind of like Boston, I thought. So that's... I went where that sort of area where I thought I'd be close to it.
OK.
Which is around there. Is that close, is it not?
Yeah, also sort of Pennsylvania-y sort of area. Izzy, what are you thinking on this one? Do you know the answer?
I don't know the answer. I love Family Guy. I think it's very funny. But no, I don't know the answer, so I kind of went within the borders.
OK. You were in Missouri there. Well, Quahog is fictional. The state it's in is Rhode Island. So it's set in Rhode Island. So the question now is, where is Rhode Island? It is there, Kyle. You get yourself another point. Very well done, Kyle. Nicely played. Well done at home. You knew that was Rhode Island and you knew where Rhode Island was. Tablets away, please. As we take another look at our leaderboard, all former champions, don't forget that. So Izzy's got 1 point, but that's going to change as
it's going to change.
But the rest of you, just 1 point between the three of you. Kyle with 5, Alex and Kay with 6 each. How about that? Who's going to be our first champion of the week? This champion of champions weeks. It's going to be an absolute crack of a week, I think. Should we play Answer Smash for the first time? Here we go. Fingers on buzzers, please. Point for a correct answer. Don't forget, you will lose a point if you buzz in and give me an incorrect answer. Only time in the show you can lose a point. Here we go. Who's going to be our first champion? Your first category is... TV presenters, those will be the pictures. What are the names of the identical main characters in the children's TV show Flower Pot Men? That is Kiell.
Bill and Ben Shepherd.
Bill and Ben Shepherd? Correct. Bill and Ben and Ben Shepherd. Bill and Ben Shepherd. Next clue, next picture. In the book of Genesis, the paradise inhabited by Adam and Eve is called the Garden of what? That is Izzy.
Edenise Van Outen
is what we were looking for, absolutely. Eden and Denise Van Outen. Next clue, next picture. The Olsen twins, who shared the role of Michelle Tanner in the US sitcom Full House, have the first names Ashley and what? That is Kay.
Ashley and Kate Olsen Humble.
Is incorrect, I'm afraid. So sorry, you lose a point. Anybody else fancy it? That's Alex.
Can you say Ashley and Kate Humble?
Is incorrect, I'm afraid. You lose a point as well. Anyone else fancy losing a point? Kyle fancies losing a point.
Mary Kate Humble?
Is correct. Mary Kate Humble is what we were looking for. Mary Kate Humble, Mary Kate Humble. Next category. It's very close at the top of this leaderboard. Clothing is the category. Those will be the pictures. What is the first name of the model who married the Duran Duran lead singer Simon Le Bon in 1985? Nobody. Let's take a look. Yasmini skirt, I was looking for.
God.
Yasmin Le Bon, miniskirt, Yasmini skirt. Next clue, next picture. Who played Legolas in the Lord of the Rings film trilogy and Will Turner in the Pirates of the Caribbean series? Kyle.
Orlando Bloomers.
Is it Orlando Bloomers? It is Orlando Bloomers. Well played, Kyle. Next one. Who was the fifth Marx brother after Groucho, Harpo, Chico and Gummo? Kyle.
Marco Polo shirt.
Is it Marco Polo shirt? You lose a point, Kyle. Alex.
Oh, no. Oh, I don't know why I buzzed in. I shouldn't have.
Well, you got that right, at least. You lose a point as well, I'm afraid, Alex. So sorry. Anyone else?
Say anything.
I'm looking for Zeppo Polo shirt. That's what I'm looking for. Zeppo and Polo shirts. Any more categories today? That's done for the day. Everyone losing points all over the place there. Shall we take a look and see who our first winner of the week is? Our first winner on this Champions Week is Kyle Smith-Bynoe. Well played, Kyle.
Yep.
Done. Kyle, you've won yourself a golden prize.
Yes!
Which of these would you like?
The water bottle, please.
The water bottle goes to Kyle. Well played, Kyle. Nicely done. And our first weekly leaderboard looks like this. Kyle is at the top of it. But it's all to play for the rest of the week. I think it's going to be a very, very close week and a good fun week as well. Shall we do it all again tomorrow?
We shall.
Look forward to seeing you here. We'll look forward to seeing you here as well on the House of Games. Flashy to take anywhere at all?
Absolutely not. No, I'll take this anywhere.
They've called him Golden Kyle. It really does go with your hair.
Thanks.